open your eyes. I want all my dear ones to be in mute, okay? I do not want anyone to interrupt in between my class. Yes, and talk in between, okay? If you have any doubts, kindly post it in the chat box. Kindly do not unmute yourself and talk in between while class is going on, okay? Yes, so let's begin. Lesson number 8, addition up to 99. Lesson number 8, addition up to 99. We are seeing this, right? Okay, we saw so many topics and today we are going to see a very important topic. I want you all to sit straight and listen to the class very carefully. Okay? Yes.
Ma'am, workbook for textbook carbon.
Kamakshi, this is not fair. I said no one to unmute in between and talk in between when my class is going on. I will be saying you to take out whatever it is. If it is a rough note or a textbook or workbook, I will be saying you what to take. Okay? And when it is to be taken out. Okay. Yes, now I want you all to sit straight and listen to the class first. Yes. Hope you are all very good children. You will not disturb in between. Yes. So, I am moving on to the lesson now. Vertical addition with carryover. Vertical addition with carryover. This will be coming you for even in the higher classes. So kindly listen very carefully. Okay, this is the base for you. Kindly listen very carefully so that it will be very helpful for you when you move on to the second standard. Yes. So now let's move on. See, the first number I have here is 16 plus 8. Okay, the first number is 16 plus 8. So for the values. Values given. Shall I stop the class if you are going to disturb in between like this? Shiv, be in mute. Yes. Thank you. Okay, so first the values will be given like this. 16 and 8. Okay. So, our first step is we have to find out the write the place values on the top. Okay, so let's write the place values on the top. So, here we have 8 ones and 0 tens. 8 ones and 0 tens. Likewise, here we have 6 ones and 1 ten. 6 ones and 1 ten. Okay, these numbers after writing the place values, we have to arrange them in the correct places of tens and ones. Correct places of tens and ones. 1 10 and 6 ones. Likewise, 0 tens and 8 ones. Okay, once we have finished writing the values in the place values, we have to add the ones place. Next step is we have to add the ones place value. Okay, so 6 plus 8. So let's have 6 in our mind and 8 in our finger. After 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 14. So this 14, we can't write it in the ones place as such. It's wrong. We should not write. Why we should not write? Why? Because here we have two-digit numbers. Two-digit numbers. This 1 stands only for the numbers till 0 to 9. Okay, till 0 to 9. This 1 stands only for the values from 0 to 9. Okay, beyond, once it reaches 10 and above, okay, 10 and above, we will be writing its place value. Okay, 10 and above, if we get the answer, 10 and above, we will be writing the place values. Okay, so since we got 14 as the answer, what we are going to do here is we are going to write the place values for the number 14. Okay, so let's write the place value for 14, 1, 10 and 4 ones. This is the answer which we got for 6 plus 8. Okay, once we have written the place value for 14, what will we do? No, we will be taking this 4 ones in the place of ones as the answer. 4 ones will sit in the place of ones place as the answer. Okay, then you know what will happen to the tens? This 10, no, it will be carried over to the tens place. It will be carried over to the tens place as the carryover. Okay, tens place as the carryover. Okay, so with the 14, first step, we brought the ones as the answer for the ones place, and tens is carried over to the tens place as the carryover. Okay, why? Because this tens always loves to sit in the place of tens, and ones always loves to sit in the place of ones. So we are regrouping them to the places of tens and ones, and then we will be calculating the answer. Okay, so since this ones has settled in the place of ones as the answer, we will move on to the tens place and let's add all the numbers together. Here we have one number, two number and three number. So what we will do when we have three numbers, we will be adding the first two number. What is 1 plus 1? 1 plus 1 is 2. With this answer 2, we will be adding the third number, that is 0. So 2 plus 0, what will happen when we add 2 plus 0? Will we get 0 as the answer? Yes, we will be getting 2 as the answer, right? Yes, 2 plus 0 is 2. 2 plus 0 is 2. When we add 0 with any number, we will be getting the same number as the answer. Here's the property. Here we should remember the property and we can apply that. Okay, shall we see whether 24 is the correct answer or not in the next slide? Yes?
Yes.
Yes.
Our answer is correct. Okay, now, hope so you're all listening to the class very keen. Yes? Yes, sit straight. Listen very carefully. Just before we did with a two-digit number on the top and one-digit number at the bottom. Okay, two-digit number on the top and one-digit number at the bottom. That is after plus. Okay, now we are going to calculate the numbers with two-digit. Okay, two-digit number adding with two-digit number. Shall we see how we are going to do that? Yes, again, I want you all to listen very carefully. Okay, yes. So, first step, they have given the numbers as 4, 47 and 28. The first step is we will be writing its place value on the top. Place value on the top. So, the first number has 4 tens and 7 ones. Likewise, 2 tens and 8 ones. Okay, so we shall place these numbers in its place value. Okay, yes, here I have arranged these numbers in the place value. Very good, Ojeshwi, Meenakshi, yes, superb. You got the answer, but still listen to the class. Okay, yes, superb. Okay, now we have finished with writing the numbers in its correct place value. Now let's move on to the next step. The second step is we will be adding the ones place value. We will be adding the ones place value. When we add ones place value, we will be getting we are getting two-digit number as the answer. How we are getting two-digit number? Shall we calculate 7 plus 8 and see whether we are getting two-digit answer? Yes? Yes. Calculate and say me the answer. 7 in the mind, 8 in the finger. After 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So, we are getting 15 as the answer. So, let's write next, that is outside the box. Okay, let's write outside the box as 15. Okay, so in this 15, the next step is we are going to write its place value. 15 has two-digit number, right? So we are going to write the place value for 15. How many tens and how many ones does 15 have? 110 and 5 ones. 110 and 5 ones. Okay, now once we have written the tens and ones place value, what is the next step? What we will be doing? We will be taking the ones to its ones place value as the answer. Okay, 5 comes and sit here as the answer. Okay, now say me, what will happen to the tens place? What will happen to the tens number? It will be carried forward to the tens place. tens place and sits in the place in the top place. Okay, and sits in the topmost place. Yes. So tens loves to sit in the place of tens, and ones loves to sit in the place of ones. So now we have arranged the numbers according to the tens and ones. Okay. Since we have got the answer for the ones, we'll be moving on to the tens place now. Okay, here we have 1 plus 4 plus 2. Okay, three numbers we have. So what we will be doing, we will be adding the first two number. What is 1 plus 4? Yes, here the property applies. When we add 1 to any number, we will be getting the next number as the answer, after number as the answer, right? 4 plus 1 is 5. So with this 5, we will be adding the third number 2. Okay, so 5 plus 2, 5 in the mind, 2 in the finger, after 5, 6, 7. So the answer which we get for 47 plus 28 is 75. 47 plus 28 is 75. So this is what you will be doing for the vertical addition with regrouping, that is with carryover. Okay, with carryover. These are very simple steps. In the assessment, I want you all to write all these steps so that you will be getting full marks for the carryover. Okay, yes, so understand the concept very well. It is very easy once you understand the concept. Now, let's move on to the next slide. I want you all to take out your textbook. Take out your textbook and turn to page number 106. Turn to page number 106. Okay, first step. Step 1, find the ones and tens in each number. Yes, as I said earlier, we have to first write its ones and tens place value for the numbers. So in the first value, we have 2 tens and 3 ones. Likewise, for the second value, we have 3 tens and 8 ones. So this is our first step. What is the second step? In the second step, we will be writing the digits of the numbers in the correct columns. According to the tens and ones, we will be writing the numbers in its places. Okay, now let's move on to the third step. Add the number in the ones column. Add the number in the ones column. So in the ones column, we have 3 ones plus 8 ones. So let's do the mind calculation. 3 in the mind, 8 in our finger. After 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So 11, we have 11. Subramani 778, kindly do not play with the smileys. Listen to the class. This vertical addition with regrouping is very important. Listen to the class. Do not play with the smileys. Yes. So we have 11 ones. 11 ones. Okay. So let's write 11 outside the box. 11 outside the box. Now let's write ones and tens place value for the number 11. Okay. What will happen to the ones? Ones will sit in the place of ones place value as the answer. Okay, 1. And what will happen to the tens? 10 will go and sit in the place of tens as the carryover. Okay, tens will go and sit in the place of tens as the carryover, and ones will sit in the place of ones as the answer. Okay, yes. So, once we have written the carryover and the answer, we will be moving on to the fourth step. We will be moving on to the, yes, carryover. Carryover we have done, right? The fifth step is we will be adding all the tens together. All the tens together. So, we have 110 plus 210s plus 310s. So, we all know that first we will be doing first two numbers, that is 1 plus 2. Here the property applies. So, we will be getting 3 as the answer. With this 3, we will be adding with the next number, that is 3. So, 3 plus 3 gives you the answer as 6. So, 61 will be our answer. 61 will be our answer. Okay, this is what, and the vertical addition with carryover is, kindly do understand the concept. Okay, now let's move on to the next. Yes, math textbook page number 104. Math textbook page number 104. Let's solve. Here we have two digit numbers, two different values are given. We have they have placed the values in the tens and ones place value. So you will be calculating the answer and you will be doing the getting the finding the answer. Okay, here you do not have any carryover. This is just a vertical addition, normal vertical addition without carryover, without regrouping, without carryover, without regrouping. We will not change any number. We will just write the answer. Okay, I will do the first sum for you and the second sum is for your practice. You have to do by yourself. Okay, so 57 plus 17, two values have been given, and the next step, we have to arrange those two values in the correct tens and ones place value. Once we have arranged the numbers in the ones and tens place value, we have to, the next step is we will be adding the ones place. So here we have two ones plus seven ones. So 2 in the mind, 7 in the finger, after 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So you will be getting 9 as the answer. Okay, here no 2 digit number, it's only 9. So you will be writing just like that. Okay, now we have finished with the ones column. Let's move on to the tens column. Here we have 5 plus 1. So 5 in the mind, 1 in the finger, after 5, 6. Here again the property applies. Yes, and we will be getting the answer as 6. 6 as the answer, so 69. We do get the answer as 69. Once you have written the answer, you will be carrying this answer to the blank and write the answer in the blank. Okay, yes, super. Now the next sum is for your practice. Once you got the answer, you will be carrying this answer and writing in the blank also. It is compulsory. You have to take out the answer and you have to write it after equal to. Okay, is that clear? Yes. Now let's move on to the next math textbook, page number 107. Math textbook, page number 107. Yes, turn to page number 107. Spot the error in each of the following case given below. Take page number 107. Okay, listen to the class first. Once the class gets over, you can do by yourself. If the concept is understood, you can do by yourself. Okay, first listen to the class. Don't be in a hurry to finish the textbook exercise and workbook exercise. Yes, first listen. Then once the class gets over, you can write by yourself. Okay. Yes. Super. Now let's see the first question. It's 32 plus 29. Okay. And the answer they have given there, it like as 51. So we have to spot where the mistake is done. Okay. So now we all know that the first step, we will be adding the ones column, right? 2 plus 9. 2 in the mind, 9 in the finger, after 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So let's write 11 outside the box, and the next step is we will be writing ones and tens place value for the number, and what we'll be doing, we'll be taking the ones to the ones place as the answer and tens to the tens place as the carryover. Okay, now the last step is we have to add all the tens values. Okay, 110 plus 3 tens plus 2 tens. So we all know that first we'll be adding first two number. 1 plus 3 gives you the answer as 4. Let's write in the box. With this 4, you'll be adding the 2 and you'll be writing the answer in the answer box. Okay, 4 plus 2. 4 in the mind, 2 in the finger, after 4, 5, 6. So let's write 6 in the box. They have given us 5. Kindly strike out the 5 and write as 6 as the answer. Yes, we have found the answer and we have spotted the error. Okay, 61 is the correct answer. 61 is the correct answer. Okay, the next sum you will be doing by yourself, and this sum also you will be doing by yourself. I'll be doing the last sum. Okay, this sum I'll do now. Okay, listen very carefully. Okay, they have arranged all the numbers and also they have given the answers. We are going to rectify where the answer, where the mistake is done. Okay, so let's calculate the ones place. 5 plus 6. 5 under mine. Someone is disturbing in between the class. I want them to be in mute. Yes, very good. Superb, thank you. 5 plus 6. So 5 in the mind, 6 in the finger. After 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So what we will do, we will be again writing the number outside the box. Outside the box. And we will be writing its place value. Tens and ones. What will happen to this one? This one will come and sit in the place of one as the answer. We will not write two numbers in the ones answer. We will be writing only one number as the answer, right? Only one single digit will be written as the answer. So strike out one. Oh, okay, or else strike out both the number and write one using your pencil as the answer for ones. Okay, and what will happen to this tens? This tens will be moving carried over to the tens place as the carry over. So let's write 110 on the top of the values, tens values. Okay, yes. Now the last step is we will be adding all the tens together. 110 plus 710 plus 110. Okay, 7 plus 1, sorry, 1 plus 7 will give you the answer as 8. So let's write 8 in the box. 8 in the box. With this 8, we will be adding the third number, that is 1. So 8 plus 1 gives you the answer as 9. They have given us 8. So let's strike out 8 and let's write 9 in the box. Tens value. So our answer is 91. Our answer is 91. Okay. The rest of the sums you will be doing by yourself. It's for your practice. Okay, dears. Yes, now let's move on to the next page. A math textbook, page number 108. Math textbook, page number 108. Okay. Yes. So, use data. Use data. So, they have been given you some data. What we are going to find out the answers for the data given and the questions asked regarding that. Okay. Yes. So, we all know about the bundles and sticks, right? So, one bundle has 10 sticks. 10 any thing or object that is grouped into 10, we will say as one bundle or one group, right? Which has 10 units in that, right? Okay, so one blue sticks goes and sits in the place of one ones. Okay, extras, blue sticks makes the value of ones. Okay, yes. So let's read out the statement given there. How many pencils do Banita and Ankita have together? How many pencils do Banita and Ankita have together? Together, what is the term related to? Together, what does this mean? Together, it means we have to add them together. Add them. Yes, very good, Ojashvi. We have to add them together. Together, add. Okay, so they are asking about Banita and Ankita. Okay, Ankita. Yes, so first circle, Banita and Ankita. Okay, so the next step, I said not to interrupt in between my class. When I am taking the class, you are not supposed to disturb me in between. Okay, yes, superb. So first, let's add all the bundles together. So it will be very easy for us to calculate. Okay. So how many bundles do Manita and Ankita have together 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 bundles, that is equal to 7 tens. 7 bundles, that is equal to 7 tens. Okay, now let's count all the extra sticks or pencils or things together. Okay, yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 extras. So we have 9 ones. 9 ones. Very good. Ojeshwi, Krishiv, yes, you are giving the answers in the chat box. Superb. So 7 tens and 9 ones makes 79. Very good, Rayan Muttarasu. Okay, 79. So we will be writing 79 as the answer. Okay, beside the question, you are going to write 79 as the answer. Okay, second sum is for your practice. You have to find out how many pencils do Ashwin and Piyush have together. Okay, now I am going to do you the third sum. Third sum. Okay, listen carefully here. Okay, how many pencils do Gaurav and Piyush have all together? How many pencils do Gaurav and Piyush have all together? Okay, again, all together means we all know that the term relates to the addition. Addition, right? Yes, super Vojeshwi, yes, very good. Yes, so now let's circle Gaurav and Piyush. Okay. And now, yes, very good, Niralaya, Rayan, yes, superb. Now, the next step, we will be adding all the bundles together. Okay, shall we add all the bundles together? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So, we have 11 tens. We have 11 tens. 11 tens. That means 110. Okay, 110. Okay, then we have how many loose sticks? 1, 2, 3. So we have 3 loose sticks, 3 extra sticks. That means 3 ones. 3 ones. Okay, so when we put together 3 11 tens and 3 ones, we will be getting the answer as 113. Okay, hundreds place value you will be learning in the higher standards, that is in the second standard. So, need not to worry about this. This will not be coming in your assessment. Okay, only up to 99 you will be getting for your assessment. Okay, yes. So, just to know, you can understand what it is. Okay, yes, it's in hundreds place. 113. Okay, yes. So, we got the answer as 113. So you are going to write 113 beside the question. Beside the question 3, you are going to write 113. Okay. Now let's move on to the next slide. Yes. Math textbook page number 109. Math textbook page number 109. Challenge yourself. Fill in the blanks. 57. They have given the value for 57. Okay, we all know how to split into tens and ones, right? Yes, in 57 we have 5 tens and 7 ones. 5 tens and 7 ones. Yes, so the first one you will be doing, second one I will do for you. Okay, 5 tens and 7 ones. So let's, they are asking for the 10, splitting up of tens, and then they have asked for the ones. So let's write the ones in the ones place as such, and now let's split up tens and write. Okay, so now we are going to split 5 into 2. Okay, so when, what are the two numbers we add together to make 5? Can I get the answers in the chat box? How we can split the 5? Yes, 3 plus 2, very good, Ojeshwi, Rayan, superb then. 1 plus 4, very good, Meenakshi, superb. 1 plus 4, anything else? Any other combination of numbers to make 5? Yes, very good, 4 plus 1, 2 plus 3, 3 plus 1, 5 plus 0, very good, superb, Nandana, Meenakshi, Rayan, Ojashvi, Superb, Superb. Yes. So we can take whatever value we want. Okay, either 4 plus 1 or 1 plus 4 or 2 plus 3 or 3 plus 2 or 0 plus 5 or 5 plus 0. Whatever number we want, we can take and put in the blank. Okay, I am going to take the first value, that is 4 plus 1. It is very easy, right? So I am going to take 4 tens and 1 ten, that makes 5 tens. 4 tens and 1 tens makes 5 tens. Okay, so I have split the tens value and ones value here. Okay, now we are going to do the last sum. Okay, third one is for you. Fourth one is for you. You are going to do by yourself. And the fifth one, I am going to do for you. Okay. Yes, 57. Likewise, we are going to split the tens and ones in the fifth question. Okay. So, seven ones. Here, they have also splitted the ones place. Seven ones. Okay. So, first let's split the tens and then let's move on to the ones place and let's split the ones. Okay. So, here we have one blank, two blank, three, four, five blanks we have. Five blanks. So, how we can split into five? One, two, three, four, five. So, shall we write 1, 1, 1, 1? 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 1, 4, 4 plus 1, 5. So, in all the blanks, we will be writing 1, 1, 1, 1 as the answer. So, 1 10 plus 1 10 plus 1 10 plus 1 10 plus 1 10 gives you 5 tens. Okay, we have finished with the tens place. Now, we are going to split up the 7th. 7, 7 ones. How we can split 7? Yes, any combination of numbers for 7? Yes, very good, Ojashvi. 3 plus 4, 2 plus 5, Nandana, very good. 6 plus 1, Ojashvi, superb. Anything else? 7 plus 0. Very good, Nandana, Ojashvi. Yes. And Avanishwar, 6 plus 1. Sorry, 1 plus 6. Superb. Yes. 6 plus 1. 7 plus 0. 3 plus. No. 5 plus 2. Yes. 3 plus 4. 4 plus 3. 5 plus 2. 1 plus 6. 0 plus 7. 2 plus 5. Yes, super. So, with all the combinations of number, we can make 7, right? So, let me take the first value. Okay, 3 plus 4. 3 plus 4 gives you 7. So, I am going to write 3 ones and plus 4 ones makes 7 ones. Okay, whatever number you like the in the combination of 7, for the combination of 7, okay, you can write whatever number you wish. Okay, yes, so this is how we will be splitting up the tens and ones.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Now I want you to take out
Sarjit Krishna is unmuted, ma'am.
Sarjit Krishna?
So it's so disturbing.
Sarjit Krishna? I want all my dear ones to be in mute. Shija sir, kindly mute everyone. Sarjit Krishna? Yes. Sarjit Krishna, kindly go and mute. Okay, now let's move on to the workbook exercise. I want you all to take out the workbook. Shridhar sir, kindly put Sarjit Krishna in lobby. Yes, so now let's move on to workbook page number 36. Take out your workbook and turn to page number 36. Turn to page number 36, worksheet 3. Add the given numbers vertically. Okay, so I'm going to do you the first sum. 29 plus 67. 29 plus 67. Okay, so the first step, we all know that we have to write the one sentence place value. Yes, for the values. So here we have 2 tens and 9 ones, likewise 6 tens and 7 ones. Okay, so let's write the values in its respective places. The second step is we will be writing the values in the respective places. 9 ones and 2 tens. Likewise, 7 ones and 6 tens. The third step is we will be adding all the ones together. So 9 in the mind, 9 plus 7. 9 in the mind, 7 in the finger. After 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So we'll be getting 16 as the answer. What we will do with the 16? Will we write 16 in the ones place value as the answer? Yes? No, right? We will not write like that. So we will be write no, yes. So we will be writing 16 beside the box. So once we have written 16, what is the next step? We will be writing its place value. Tens and ones place, since it has two numbers, two digits, we will be writing its place values. And what will happen to ones? Ones will go and sits in the place of ones answer. And what will happen to tens? Tens will go and sits in the place of tens as the carry over. Okay, now the fourth step is we will be adding all the tens together. 110 plus 210 plus 610. So we all know that first we will be adding first two number, that is 1 plus 2 gives you the answer as 3, right? So let's write 3 in the box. Okay, with this 3 we will be adding the third number, that is 6. 3 plus 6, 3 in the mind, 6 in the finger. After 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So that 9 we will be writing as the answer in the tens place. Okay, so 96. We got the answer as 96. Okay, now let's move on to the pictures given here. What is the picture represents? It represents the set of necklace and loose beads. Extra beads. Okay, here with the concept of unit cubes and longs, we are going to calculate the answer. Okay, do not get confused with this and vertical carryover. Okay, vertical carryover is very important. Kindly do understand that concept. Okay, this concept is for your better understanding, also for the cross checking. Okay, yes, so we all know that one group, one set has 10 objects or 10 things in that. Okay, shall we see whether this necklace set has 10 in count? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we have 10 beads together, which makes one set, one group. So we have 110, 210, 310, 410, 510, 610, 710, and 810. Okay, so let's write 8 tens. Okay, 8 tens. It is under the concept of unit cubes and longs. Okay, so 8 tens, 8 sets of necklace. Okay, now let's move on to the extra beads, loose beads. Okay, yes, here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, we all know that we will be grouping, once it reaches 10, we will be grouping them together, right? So let's group them together and make 110. One group, so 110. 110. Okay? 110. So now let's count the remaining beads. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Only 6 extras are there, so it means 6 ones. 6 ones. Okay, 6 ones. So we all know that we will be putting all the tens together. Okay, yes, so when we put tens together, what will happen? 8 10 plus 1 10 gives you 9 10. 8 10 plus 1 10 gives you 9 10. 9 tens. 9 tens. Okay, and we have 6 ones. So 9 tens and 6 1 gives you the answer. 96. So see the answer here. Here also we got the answer as 96. And here also we got the answer as 96. So our answer is correct. Okay, yes, this is how you will be doing the sum. Okay, you can write both the concept and you can try of your own. Okay, I'll be doing this. Okay, 2 more minutes more. Okay, so the rest of the sum is for your practice. Okay, yes. So in workbook page number 38, we do have addition problems with or without carryover, but all the sums has carryover. So what you will be doing, you will be placing the numbers in its correct places. Okay, first step, you will be writing the one sentence place value on the top, and then you will be writing the numbers in its places. And once you have written the numbers in its places, the place values, you will be adding the next step is you will be adding the ones column. The ones column, when you add, you will be getting 2-digit number. Okay, if you get 2-digit number, you will be writing beside the box, that is out of the box, and then you will be writing place value for that. And with that place values, tens will be carried over to the tens place, and ones will be carried over to, ones will be brought down to the answer. Ones answer. Okay, then once we have finished with the ones column, we'll be moving on to the tens column. There, with the carryover, you will be having 3 numbers. Okay, 3 numbers. So first we'll be adding first 2 numbers, and then with that answer, we'll be adding the second, last, third number, and then we'll be writing the answer. Okay, so you'll be getting the answers in such a way. Okay, Kanna, I want you all to practice all the sums. This carryover is very, 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 very important. Kindly do understand the concept. In further classes also, we will be revising all carryover with and without carryover again and again. Do not worry. Now you practice all the sums. Okay, we have sent you the assignment, math assignment, right? Okay, that coin building. I want you all to do the math project work. Okay, the best project work will be selected for the newsletter. Okay, yes. So we will be meeting you in the next class. Thank you so much. Now it's time to move. Bye bye. Take care. Bye everyone. Bye bye, Kanna. Practice all the sums. Yes, thank you so much. It's to practice.
Thank you, ma'am.
The sums. Yes, superb. Bye bye. Bye everyone. Thank you.